Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Human Diseases and You. In this video, I will discuss about Sandhoff disease. Sandhoff disease was first described by Dr. Herman Sandhoff and his colleagues in the 1960s. Dr. Sandhoff, a German biochemist, identified the disease as a rare genetic disorder related to the deficiency of hexosaminidase enzyme, which leads to the accumulation of GM2 gangliosides in nerve cells. This discovery was crucial in understanding the biochemical and genetic basis of the disease. Sandhoff disease is a rare inherited neurodegenerative disorder that is a part of a group of conditions known as GM2 gangliosidoses. It is characterized by the progressive accumulation of GM2 gangliosides in the brain and other tissues due to deficiencies in hexosaminidase enzyme. It is a rare genetic disorder and its prevalence varies by geographic region and population. Sandhoff disease is estimated, the prevalence of Sandhoff disease is estimated to approximately 1 in 2,000, 2 lakh to 1 in 3 lakh live births worldwide. The prevalence of Sandhoff disease is higher in Ashkenazi Jewish population due to a higher carrier frequency of the HEXA and HEXB gene mutation. Symptoms of Sandhoff disease include speech difficulties, seizures, peripheral neuropathy, intellectual disability, dementia, loss of motor skills, developmental delay, and regression. Sandhoff disease is classified on the basis of age of onset of symptoms such as infantile Sandhoff disease, juvenile Sandhoff disease, and late onset Sandhoff disease. Infantile Sandhoff disease is the most severe form. Infants typically appear normal initially but development slow, and they may lose previous acquired motor skills like sitting, crawling, and rolling over. Muscles become weak and there may be increased muscle tone, that is spasticity, leading to stiff limbs. Seizures are common. Infants react excessively to loud noise, that is exaggerated startle response. Cherry red spots are observed in the eye during an examination. Liver and spleen are enlarged, that is hepatosplenomegaly. Progressive vision and hearing loss can occur. Infantile Sandhoff disease is usually fatal in early childhood. Symptoms of juvenile Sandhoff disease appear in early to late childhood, including dementia, cerebral ataxia, and abnormal gait. Late onset Sandhoff disease form present in adulthood with symptoms such as progressive muscle weakness, loss of appetite, vomiting, difficulties with swallowing, peripheral sensory neuropathy, cerebral dysfunction, and slow developing executive functions, intellectual disability, and memory deficit. In some late onset cases, individuals may experience psychosis, mania, or mood disorders like anxiety or depression. Mutations in the HEXA and HEXB genes cause the hexosaminidase A and B enzyme deficiency. The HEXA gene is located on long arm of chromosome 15 at Q23 band, consists of 14 exons and approximately 40 kilobases in length. It provides instruction for the alpha subunit of the enzyme beta-hexosaminidase A, a vital component of the cellular lysosomal system responsible for breaking down the fatty substance GM2 gangliosides. HEXB gene is located on chromosome 5 at Q13.3 band, consists of 14 exons and is 45 kb long. It encodes the beta subunits of the beta-hexosaminidase enzyme, which is essential for breaking down complex sugars and fatty substances called sphingolipids within cell lysosome. The HEXB gene is critical for the function of beta-hexosaminidase A enzyme with a beta and alpha subunit, and beta-hexosaminidase B with two beta subunits. Mutations in the HEXB gene lead to Sandhoff disease resulting from the buildup of GM2 gangliosides in neurons. Sandhoff disease is inherited in an autosomal recessive pattern. An individual must inherit two copies of mutated gene to develop the disorder. Both HEXA and HEXB genes must be affected to cause the disease. Sandhoff disease is diagnosed through a combination of clinical evaluation, biochemical, that is enzymatic test, and molecular genetic test. A doctor will diagnose Sandhoff disease by assessing the symptoms such as progressive neurological impairment, developmental delay, seizure, vision and hearing loss, and an exaggerated startle response to noise. CT or MRI imaging of brain is performed to look for signs of cerebral atrophy, increased density in the thalamus, and white matter changes. Individuals with Sandhoff diseases will have abnormally low or absent activity of both enzymes. Diagnosis often involves measuring the activity of HEXA and HEXB enzymes in blood or tissue samples. Reduced enzyme activity indicates Sandhoff disease. Analysis of urine for increased level of certain oligosaccharides can also help support the diagnosis. Genetic testing confirms the diagnosis by identifying mutations in the HEXB gene. Identifying biallelic pathogenic variants in HEXB provides a definitive diagnosis. For families with a known history of Sandhoff disease, prenatal testing can be done during pregnancy. Techniques like chorionic villi sampling or amniocentesis can provide samples for enzymes and genetic analysis to diagnose the condition before birth. There is no cure for Sandhoff disease, and treatment focuses on supportive and palliative care to manage symptoms and improve the patient's quality of life. A team of specialists, including neurologists, physiotherapists, and dietitians, provide care. Anticonvulsant medications are used to control seizures. Maintaining good nutrition and hydration is crucial. Drugs like miglustat are being explored for their potential to slow disease progression by reducing the accumulation of harmful substances. Genetic counseling should be provided for affected families. This is all about Sandhoff disease. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe my channel for more health insight. Share this video with friends or families to spread awareness. Don't miss my next video. Until then, stay informed and take care of your health. Thank you very much.